As a Jewish student, attending Muhlenberg College and studying life on campus during the World War II era, I wanted to get a sense of what concerned students, particularly what was on the minds of Jewish students. To find out more, I turned to the archives. Luckily, I found my answer. Students attended Muhlenberg College for their higher studies with the knowledge that one day, those days might turn into war. In 1932, as Adolf Hitler rose to power, Muhlenberg College's community began to question what the future held for them. Using the student-run newspaper, the Muhlenberg Weekly, students expressed their concerns about Hitler, about the possibility of the United States entering World War II, and about their future. The Weekly featured stories about Hitler's activities and op-eds about imminent threats to European allies and to the United States. The reality of U.S. democracy holding together while Hitler was on the move worried students and the college, ranging from the fear of the U.S. establishing fascist principles to the concern about aiding our allies Britain and France who were succumbing to German aggression. One op-ed columnist for the Weekly was Bertram Levenstone, a Jewish student in the class of 1942. Levenstone was active in sports, band, the French Club, the Chess Club, and Phi Epsilon Pi. His column, One Man's Opinion, was a voice of the community, a voice lived in orderliness amidst a chaotic world. In September 1940, he wrote a rather tongue-in-cheek piece about the United States being fervently engaged in the greatest peacetime preparations for war it has ever seen. And while he wrote about local events on campus, he also wrote about national events, comparing them to the plight of our European allies when he pondered over Roosevelt's possible third term and compared its peculiar similarities to the rise of fascism. Roosevelt running for a third term seemed suspicious due to the time's world affairs. The student body combated their fear by studying the world's latest developments. Students also wrote about dances, freshman events, sports, and class schedules for next year. However, the danger of war still loomed over their heads. The speakers that came to the college that students covered in the paper spoke about Hitler and the war, and Bertram Levenstone presented various aspects of dictatorship, democracy, and the Muhlenberg community in his column. Let's cherish peace, he wrote in his column in the days before serving in World War II as a military doctor. Like other writers, Levenstone kept a low profile towards his religious affiliation in his work. Writing today as I do for the Weekly, my faith sometimes factors into my articles. I wonder, however, had I been in Levenstone's place, writing in the early 1940s, how I would have even considered being so open about my faith.